Welcome to our series on working AI. Today I'm joined by Ayushi to talk about going beyond RAG, how Glean brings AI to work. Ayushi, can you introduce yourself?
Thanks for having me. I'm Ayushi Mithakin. I have been at Glean for around 2.5 years now, and here I lead a team that works on assistant quality.
Awesome. Thanks for joining me today.
Of course.
So when companies think about bringing AI to work, they often think about using an LLM for reasoning and pairing it with a vector database for knowledge. Why is this retrieval-augmented generation, or RAG, architecture becoming so prevalent in the enterprise?
So if we take a very simple example of a salesperson writing an email to a prospect, the system needs to know who this person is who's writing the email, who the prospect is, maybe where they are in the sales cycle. And so what RAG does in a very simple way is just takes this knowledge base that the company has and at query time, send it to the LLM. And now the LLM is able to make use of all of this information and give a better response.
Yeah, so many LLMs, they're trained on public knowledge, as you said, and so RAG gives an opportunity to add in more company-specific insights. But there's another issue that LLMs have, and that's around hallucinations. Can you speak a little bit more towards the challenge of hallucinations for enterprises?
We have a search system that does the RAG for us, and we really trust that search system. We know that it's able to get the best quality results. So we tune our overall system in a way that it's only relying on information that comes from there and doesn't try to hallucinate. The second thing that we do is make sure that everything that the system responds with is actually grounded in something that it has retrieved in terms of documents from the knowledge base, and it's able to use only that information. And then we also make sure that everything that the user is shown is cited, and the user is able to verify these citations so that they can also build this trust in the system and know where this information is coming from. So all of these pieces actually need to work well individually and need to work well together for the system to truly be useful.
We've been looking at RAG as the solution to challenges with relevancy and accuracy of LLMs. I'm curious, where does RAG fall short?
So unfortunately, it's not the case that a company can just have their knowledge base, put it in a vector database, and hook it up to an LLM, and they're done. It does take a lot of pieces to actually make a system that makes use of this AI well, right? First of all, you need to figure out what data to use in the system. So these are documents that are present in the company's knowledge base. There's a lot of unstructured data within them, but also a lot of structured metadata, like who's the author of the document, who is visiting this, how many people have visited it, so how popular it is. Next, you need to figure out how to make all of this searchable. So the system should actually work in real time. It should be low latency. It should be scalable as the number of documents grow, and so on. Next, like with all of these signals and information, we need to figure out how to actually rank these documents better. So the ranking should be a very good mix of popularity, topicality, personalization, and getting all of this right is not very easy. The next thing that the system needs to figure out is whether the LLMs need to be fine-tuned, because often even with all of this RAG, the LLM needs to know how to respond in this specific scenario, and fine-tuning sometimes helps with that. Next, even after all of this, the LLM probably needs some prompt tuning to explicitly give it instructions on how to use all of this information and process it in the best way. And then for any system, it should have monitoring. It should have basics like feedback systems. It should be able to process information like clicks, and we should be able to use all of that to keep making the system better. So all of these pieces are much more complex than just a very simple RAG-based system. And all of these need to work well individually, work well together for the system to really work and be useful.
Thanks for that context and really breaking down why this is not a simple problem. Let's switch into Glean a bit. How does Glean use RAG?
So a lot of companies have tried to do this in-house, right? Build a RAG-based system and connect AI to their company. But unfortunately, it's a difficult problem to get right. And I think what is unique with Glean is that this is the main thing that we focus on. And there's so many engineers who are dedicated to make all of these pieces of the puzzle that I was describing before work well and work well together. So for example, we have spent so much time doing search and making it better. And now we are at that position where we know that we are able to find the best pieces of content. It's content that's most personalized to the user. It's topical to the question that they are asking. It's some of the most popular things that are being used across the company. And so RAG is an important piece still at Glean, but it's just one of those pieces that work well with all the other pieces that the engineers have built. And that's how we are, I think, able to make a system that's actually useful to bring AI at work.
And how does Glean go beyond RAG?
So let's take the example that I was talking about before, which is a salesperson writing an email to a prospect. So in this journey, the system needs to understand so many different things. The first step is understanding who this prospect is. And this information will typically be found in Salesforce or some database. The next is figuring out what recent conversations have been happening with this prospect. So that'll be found in some emails or maybe some messaging platform like Slack or Microsoft Teams. And at this point, Glean connects to hundreds of different applications, and it's able to find this information from anywhere that it exists. The next thing is figuring out what content should go in this email. And for that, the salesperson will not have access to every single document that exists in the organization. So Glean actually understands all of these complex permission structures that come with all of these different applications that we connect to. And we're able to find only information that this person has access to and use that to answer questions. So I think often when we talk about RAG, we kind of oversimplify the search problem, which is actually very complex in its own. So there are cases where keyword-based search is the best, where, for example, if you're trying to find the customer and you're trying to use just the name of the customer to do that. There are other times where semantic search works better. Say you're trying to find similar emails just using the tone of the email or some content around it. And so what Glean does is it has kind of a hybrid approach where we unify these two ways of doing search and are able to actually get the best pieces of content out for the user. And this is, again, just still a glimpse into what Glean does. There's so many other complex pieces that need to work well together to make this happen.
Thank you. I appreciate the time.